Hi, I'm Shane with etrailer.com. Today you're going to be taking a look at, I'm going to walk you through the installation on the Timbren rear suspension enhancement setup for your 2014 Toyota Tacoma. These are going to be designed to work with your factory leaf springs to add support to your factory suspension to make your ride quality much better when you're handling a load. This is what our Timbrens look like when they're installed. If you notice, I have the old jounce up right here next to it. You notice the difference. From the top of our old jounce stop to the edge of the frame rail, there's quite a bit of a gap there. With our new one, there's a lot less gap, so we're gonna get a lot less movement, sway, and body roll out of our vehicle as we would with our factory one. These are gonna be constructed of an ion rubber, so they're gonna be very durable. They're hollow in the center, so they're gonna compress. When they compress, they're gonna compress vertically, not horizontally. That's gonna help keep the spring from getting damaged from any other components underneath the vehicle. These are gonna have a load limit of 3,000 pounds, but I recommend always checking the owner's manual of your vehicle to make sure the vehicle can withstand the amount of weight. You always wanna go with the lowest number. When comparing the Timbrens to similar types of springs like the Sumo springs, some reviews from people say that the Timbrens have a little bit rougher of a ride. They are a much thicker rubber, which is gonna make it a little bit stiffer. That being said, the Timbrens are gonna have a higher weight carrying capacity than the Sumo springs. It's gonna be a matter of personal opinion. If you can handle a little bit rougher ride, you're getting more weight capacity out of these. If you want more of a softer ride, a little bit more light duty hauling, Sumo springs would be a good set of springs to go with. Before we begin our installation, we're going to take a few measurements to get our factory ride height. What we're going to do is we're going to measure from right down the center of our wheel from the ground to this edge right here. We're going to do that on the front and the back. So without it loaded, it's like we're at 35 3/4 in the back. Let's take a measurement of the front. Looks like we're right at 34. Now let's add some weight and see what it does for our vehicle. Now that we've added about 1,500 pounds to the back of the vehicle, let's go ahead and take another measurement and see how much it changed. We're at about 32.5. Our factory ride height was actually 35 3/4, which is here. So we actually dropped that much. Now let's take a measurement of the front and see what it did. So our factory ride height was actually 34. And we've only come up about 3/4 inch. So that tells us as we add weight, the front of our vehicle raises up. Now, keep in mind, we're right over the axle. If we are pulling a trailer that might have more tongue weight on it, the front of our vehicle may come up more. Well, that's gonna cause a lot of issues. It could cause your headlights to come up, not aim at the road anymore. Your steering's gonna be really light. It's gonna affect your braking because most of your braking in a vehicle is on the front. Your back brakes just assist your front one. So if those wheels are up off the ground or at least not touching the ground as much, you're not gonna get as much braking power out of the front, which can be dangerous. It's gonna cause unnecessary wear and tear on your tires because when your vehicle raises up, those tires will turn in like this and then you're just running on edges. You're gonna put unnecessary wear and tear, it's gonna cost you money later on. Now, what does it do to the back of the vehicle? Well, when you put weight on, whatever your suspension can't handle, your axle has to make up for it. So that's gonna put unnecessary wear and tear, not only on your suspension, but on your axle, and it's gonna cost you more money later on down the road. Now let's go ahead and take another measurement. Now with our Timbrens installed, same amount of weight in the back of the truck. With them, we're at 33 3/4. Our factory ride height was 35 3/4. That being said, keep in mind, these are not adjustable springs. These are just designed to work with your factory suspension so you're not overloading your axle. Here in the front, we're at 34.5. So we're right about level to where we were on factory ride height. Now, although the Timbren springs aren't going to give you any adjustability, they are gonna reduce the amount of sag the back of your vehicle has. If you're looking for something that you can adjust, an airbag might be the way to go. You can adjust the air pressure to bring your vehicle back up to the normal ride height. Now that we've gone over some of the features, let's show you how to get it installed. First thing you're going to do is remove your spare tire. It's going to make it a little bit easier to for your installation. Now, I have this on a stand. I'm also using this kind of a stand to separate my axle from my frame rail. If you're doing it at home, You can use jack and regular jack stands. What you want to do is you want to jack up the vehicle, put your jack stands under each frame rail to get your axle to drop. You want space in between there for the new sumo springs. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to take a 3/4 inch socket. Your U-bolts that run over top of your springs, you're going to have one on this side of the axle and one on the other side. You're going to have 4 nuts on the bottom. Spray those threads down with some penetrating oil just to kind of knock off any debris or anything like that that might be caught in the threads. Take a 3/4 inch socket and we're going to loosen the nuts. We're not going to take them all the way off. Like that. So it gives you enough space in there where you can lift these up. You're going to remove your factory jounce stop. Now that we have our old one removed, we need to assemble our new spring. Notice a large hole in the top, small hole in the bottom. There's going to be a washer down inside. We're going to take the small hole, this bracket, we're going to line it up right here. Just like that. Take your Allen head bolt, come up through the bottom, right through the center. You're going to have a nut. We need to take that nut, we need to get down inside and put it on top of that bolt. Then we're going to take a 14 millimeter deep well, a 7/32 Allen wrench, and we're going to tighten the nut down. Now we'll take our new one, we're going to set it in place where our old one was. Get our springs back over the top, and then we're going to tighten our nuts back down. Once you've got one side done, repeat the process on the other side, reinstall your spare tire, and you're ready to go. I'm Shane with etrailer.com. I hope this video has helped you, whether you're still deciding on a rear suspension enhancement setup or installing the Timbrens on your 2014 Toyota Tacoma.